Hi, today we are going to solve the first question from 2nd International Maths Olympiad, held in 1960. The question goes like this. Determine all 3-digit numbers n having the property that n is divisible by 11 and n by 11 is equal to the sum of the squares of the digits of n. The question sounds interesting. Do pause the video to think of the solution yourself, because now I'm going to lead you towards solution. The question says, it's a 3-digit number. We can represent a 3-digit number in the form of 100p plus 10q plus r, where p, q and r are the digits at hundreds, tens and ones place respectively. Now, the question says, this 3-digit number, when divided by 11, is equal to the sum of the square of its digits, which means 100p plus 10q plus r divided by 11 equals to p square plus q square plus r square. Let this be equation 1. Okay, so what do we do next? Next, we utilize the other information given in the question. The question says, this number is divisible by 11. We know when a number is divisible by 11, the sum of digits in odd positions minus the sum of digits in even positions is either 0 or is divisible by 11. Let's make two cases out of this. One is, when the difference between sum of digits in odd positions and sum of digits in even positions is 0, and another is when it is divisible by 11. For case 1, that is when the difference between sum of digits in odd positions and sum of digits in even positions is 0, p plus r minus q equals to 0, or p plus r equals to q. We now replace the value of q with p plus r in equation 1 and get 100p plus 10p plus r by 11 equals to p square plus p plus r whole square plus r square. We go on simplifying this equation until we get this form. Let this equation be equation 2. Now, what we'll do is, we'll substitute either p or r equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 0 in this equation. We know that p cannot be 0, as if p becomes 0, the 3-digit number will no longer remain 3-digit number but will be reduced to 2-digit. Since we'll have one less substitution to do with p as compared to r, let's substitute the value of p. When p is equal to 1, our equation takes this form. Since we get r value in decimal, which means r is not an integer, there will not be an n value for p equals to 1. Similarly, we substitute p equals to 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9 in equation 2 and get the following values of r. We can see that we do not get a feasible value r for any value of p, except for p equals to 5, where we get r equals minus 9 by 2 and 0. So, none of these values of p except p equals to 5 have the possibility of giving an appropriate q and required n. Since 9 by 2 is not a natural number, not even an integer, we deny this value and take r equals to 0, the feasible value. So, when p equals to 5, r equals to 0 and q equals to p plus r equals to 5 plus 0 equals to 5. So, the number with the difference between sum of odd digits and even digits equals to 0 is 550. Let's move on to another case. This is when the difference between sum of digits at odd positions and at even positions is divisible by 11. One interesting thing about a 3-digit number divisible by 11 is the difference between sum of digits at odd positions and at even positions is actually 11. It is because no matter how hard we try, we can't get the required difference to be more than 11. For the greatest difference between the sum of digits at odd positions and at even positions, let us assume the first digit at hundreds place to be 9 and also the last digit at one's place to be 9. This gives us 18. So, even if we were to place 0 at 10's place, we can't get the difference to be more than 18. So, the number divisible by 11 less than 18 could be 11. For case 2, therefore, we take the difference between sum of digits at odd positions and at even positions to be 11. This gives us p plus r minus q equals to 11, or q equals to p plus r minus 11. Now, we replace this value of q into our equation 1 and get 100p plus 10p plus r minus 11 plus r by 11 equals to p square plus p plus r minus 11 whole square plus r square. We go on simplifying this equation until we get this form. Once again, we substitute p equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9 and get the following values of r. We can see that we do not get a proper value of r for any value of p except for p equals to 5 and p equals to 8. So, none of these values of p except p equals to 5 and p equals to 8 have the possibility of giving an appropriate q and required n. As for p equals to 5, we get r equals to 7 by 2 and 3, and for p equals to 8, we get r equals to 1 by 2 and 3. Since 7 by 2 and 1 by 2 is not a natural number, we deny this value and take r equals to 3, which is a natural number and a feasible value. Let's find out the value of q with p equals to 5 and r equals to 3. So, q will be p plus r minus 11 equals to 5 plus 3 minus 11 equals to minus 3. Since we cannot get one of the digits of a number to be negative, there will not be any n for this value of p either. Let's now see if we get a feasible q for p equals to 8 and r equals to 3. In this case, q will be p plus r minus 11 equals to 8 plus 3 minus 11 equals to 0, which is a feasible value. So, n will exist for this value of p and it will be 803. So, the number with the difference between sum of digits at odd positions and sum of digits at even positions divisible by 11 is 803. So, we got two numbers, 550 and 803, which satisfy the conditions given in the question. Having said this, we have solved our question. Stay tuned for more videos on Olympiad. Do make a comment for suggestions and opinions if any.